Greetings, I am the Cartoon Hero, and welcome to the fourth week of Star Wars Month. Well, now Star Wars is owned by the House of Mouse, but just because the Clone Wars was cancelled due to negotiations over the rights, that doesn't mean that the Star Wars cartoons had ended, because in 2014, Disney premiered their own CG series, Star Wars Rebels. And it's clear that Disney wanted to do this new series right. In fact, they even brought in Dave Filoni from the Clone Wars to produce, along with Greg Wiseman, one of the guys who gave us Spectacular Spider-Man, and Simon Kinberg, who's been a writer and producer for several movies. Some good, some bad, and some just okay. Granted, Wiseman left the show after season one, but I won't hold that against it. Mostly because today we're just going to be looking at the pilot movie. Why? Because this series hasn't even finished yet, and I've already reviewed four different other series this month. I'm not exactly insane enough to run myself ragged over the sake of a series that doesn't even have an endpoint yet. Anyway, Star Wars Rebels is actually one of the few series here that doesn't take place during the Clone Wars era. Instead, it takes place 14 years after Episode 3 and 5 years before A New Hope. The Jedi are still being hunted, with few of them left. But the spark of rebellion has been ignited, and the Empire will soon have some new foes to contend with. And we'll see how that rebellion begins as we take a look at the Star Wars Rebels pilot, Spark of Rebellion.